Hello everyone, in this lesson we will set up AOVs, also known as render passes. By using AOVs, you can create a separate image sequence for any element in your scene, such as reflection, lighting, or any specific object or material. And the best part, AOVs don't increase render time. As far as I know, they are a very useful addition to your main render. Let's begin. Go to render settings, AOVs tab, click on add AOV, and I'll select emission. This will create a separate file just for materials which have emission in them. You can't preview render passes in production rendering mode, so let's open ActiveShare and see if emission AOV is working. You can see materials with emission are only being rendered in this layer. The eyes are not showing because there is a transparent object on top of them. Even the chest piece is not accurate. It also has transparent material wrapped around it. Here you can add new AOV group or add inside the same one, since EXR files can hold multiple channels. Let's select transmission for the transparent materials. By the way, if you are using the latest version of Max, they have added a nice AOV manager. Can add AOV group from here and drag AOVs from this list. You can add custom AOVs from here. I'll show how to set them up in a bit. And at last, select output path over here. The rest is same as the older version. Okay, let's go back. As I said, one EXR file can hold multiple AOV channels, but I don't recommend adding multiple channels in one file. Because the way it works in compositing softwares is that you have to add another effect on the EXR sequence to extract or select a specific channel inside it, which slows down RAM preview quite a lot. So by keeping one AOV channel in one EXR file, there is no need for that unnecessary effect. Your channel will show up by default. Before we go ahead, let me tell you guys about Envato Elements. It's a website with huge collection of digital assets like stock video, images, music, fonts, graphic templates, etc, etc, and my favorite, video templates. You get unlimited access to all of this with a monthly or yearly subscription. Compared to other stock websites, this one is like 10 times cheaper. I've been using this for over 2 years now, and let me briefly tell you what you're gonna get. In stock videos, you get access to millions of videos shot on professional cameras, but that's not all. In that, there's animated backgrounds, transitions, particle simulations, action packs for VFX, even animals and birds on green screen. With graphic templates and elements, there's also add-ons in which you get presets and actions to automatically add effects on your images, and a variety of brushes for digital painters. But the biggest time saver for me would be the video templates. There's not only slideshows and corporate templates. There's editable action packs, animated icons, logo animations, lower thirds, special effects. There's even rigged 2D characters. I highly recommend trying Envato Elements yourself. You can use the link in the description and support me in the process. Alright, let's continue. Alright, now I'll make one for the golden material. For this one, we will need to set up a custom AOV since we want the entire material instead of its reflection or something. So let's open the material editor. There are two ways to set up custom AOVs. In first method, create a node AOV write RGB. See that it's attached to the golden material. Then connect this to the multisub object. In the node settings, type in AOV name. This is important. It's not just for naming purpose. Then set the AOV input to white. This way the golden material will render as white color and the rest will be black. Now to add a custom AOV, click add AOV file and simply type in the AOV name we gave it in the node. Add to list. Add it to a set of AOVs which we want to render. I'll rename this group as materials. Let's check ActiveShed and you can see a golden material rendering as white. Let's disconnect this and connect it to the base layer. Now let's check. It's still not giving accurate result. It's rendering dust and all as well. No worries, we have another way to set it up. This one is a lot simpler. Go to the material. Close all of this and in AOVs panel, type AOV name and in color select white. Let's reconnect the material to the layer shader. Since we have already added a custom AOV with same name in our render settings, we don't have to do it again. Now it's giving accurate result. I've used the same technique to add a bunch of materials which I think may require editing during compositing. Right now I've added these AOVs in active shade mode for testing to see if they are working exactly the way we want. So now add them again in production rendering mode. Once that is done, let's do other render settings. In output size, I'll select HDTV. You can also type in the video resolution you want in here. Go down to render output and select the folder you want to render in. Your main render as well as AOVs will get saved in this one folder, unless you are using the latest version of Max. Then you can give a separate output for AOVs. Give file name and file type. I'm gonna select OpenEXR. This will give a good quality render. Hit save and the settings for OpenEXR will pop up. In format, select 16-bit and make sure the type is set to RGBA. Here A is your alpha channel, which will give you the transparent background. Now go to Arnold renderer. Here you can set values for these parameters, which will define the quality of each one. Since we are not using subsurface scattering on any of our materials, we can keep this at 0. The default values are this. Increasing camera samples will increase the overall quality of the render. Diffusion specular can stay the same. Transmission I'll increase it to 4. Transparent materials need more samples or they come out a bit grainy. Keep in mind that increasing sample values will also increase your render time. The rest of the settings you can keep as it is. The engineer who made this software are pretty smart. Default values work well. In system we have bucket size. I recommend keeping it as low as possible if you have a weak computer. By keeping it 16, each thread in your processor will render a box of 16 by 16 pixels at a time. So keeping smaller box will give less stress to your processor. Next we have threads. Here we can tell Max how many threads it can use. If auto detect is checked, it will use all the available threads. I'll uncheck this. My processor has 4 threads. I'm gonna use only 3 for rendering because my PC lags a lot if it uses all 4. This way the rendering will be slower, but I can still do other stuff on my computer. The rest settings can be default. Select camera view in the viewport and let's do a test run. I'll set half resolution. Forgot to rename this group. Alright, hit render. I'll render last frame, it has all the materials showing. Here you can see 3 boxes or buckets since we are using 3 threads. Alright, it's rendered. This frame took 5.5 minutes to render and we got 3 files. Our main render, light AOV group and materials AOV group. Let's call them in After Effects. Light AOV won't show up just like that. Like I said before, we'll have to use an effect. In 3D channel, select extractor. Click on this area. In layers, select one you want to call. Here you can apply glow or whatever to just this layer. We will do all that while compositing. Anyways, now we know it's rendering properly. So I'll delete these files and start final rendering. Here select active time segment to render all the frames. You can select range if you want to render a specific part of your timeline. I'm just gonna render all frames. Okay, set resolution back to full HD and finally hit render. Alright, in the next lesson we will call everything in After Effects and do compositing. All the time taking stuff is now over. Next lesson will definitely be less boring. Thanks for watching guys, hope you learned something new and if you have any doubts, let me know in the comment section. See ya!